Hello, everyone, and thank you for having me. I'm a bit tired, but I'm going to do the best that I can. So, my speech today will be on multidimensionality, on DNA, how it's a cosmic antenna for God energy or cosmic energy, Tesla, and how a lot of his work was hidden on the Tesla coil, which I do know from a lot of research that it was about lighting up the DNA so everybody could have free energy, that everybody would be connected to the universe. Of course, a lot of that was hidden. Then I will speak about ancient tech and how it's lit up by our energy. And the world is a sort of a matrix system that keeps everybody in until they become enlightened and illuminated. And all of this ancient tech that the government tries to hack into and use, it's not going to light up until humanity lights up. So I will be speaking about these subjects. I'm going to start on, DNA and the cosmic energy antenna. So I found out, I've worked with a lot of people around the world, I have found out that people who are sick, people who are in depression, people who are, who are energy vampires, they're in void of energy, of soul energy. Now, we have, in religion, we hear that the soul is eternal. So we know that energy is eternal somehow. They don't explain to you how the soul is eternal. They just say you're eternal. So everyone assumes they're going to die, and that it's going to be okay because they're eternal. The thing is they haven't explained to you that unless you build up your soul energy, that you will literally be, brought into a river of cosmic energy and sort of regurgitated out. And all of these things were made from a long time ago, from past worlds that have been rehashed in the energy machine. And, this could be people or beings. So they don't tell you that energy is reused, And to pass that stage, you have to build up your energy enough so that you can be eternal. You will be eternal, but you might be an inanimate object. That's the thing. So when religion tells you you are eternal, they're not telling you all of the basics of how you're eternal. So I found, I often worked with people who had done, some people had done great harm to others. I would be intuitively pulled to them, and I'd find out that, maybe if they were horrible to a lot of people, they might wind up as a toilet bowl or something in the next life, an inanimate object, and that energy would be rehashed as such. And in Egyptian culture, in cultures like Sumerians and stuff, they show you, if you build up your soul energy, you will surpass that. You will continuously incarnate into different dimensions, into different worlds, and so on, and be eternal, and keep yourself, and you will be giving very beautiful divine things. The wings, the depiction of the wings does not mean you would have literal wings, but that you would fly on a soul level. So a lot of these things were symbolic. And by working with a lot of people, I found this out. And I found out that people who were murderers, people who were who had abused people, they were void of soul energy, and they were going after other people's soul energy, children's soul energy, or things like that. And when they didn't have enough soul energy, their aura and their chakra system would shut down, and this would allow lower energies to infiltrate them and essentially feed off of them until they were depleted. So the body, the DNA, is a cosmic antenna. When the antenna is lit up by you taking care of yourself, by you instilling chi, by you detoxing, and especially heavy metal chelation, I'll get to that, and how there's a war on consciousness right now, on a cellular war on consciousness, you start to evolve and you start to become multidimensional. As you do that, more energy streams into you, and essentially, you become what they call divine. And it says that the souls of the divine are eternal. What I notice is that the war on consciousness has to do with keeping the cosmic DNA antenna shut down. There's a lot of stories in the Bible about, the Tower of Babel. I mean, the Tower of Babel is a very interesting story. building a tower, you're not going to get to heaven. You know, we know this. We go to space. So what were they doing? They were very smart back then, but they were building a tower to get to heaven? That's ridiculous. It's encoded. The tower was the DNA. And the, quote, slaves that were helping build the tower were people that were giving their energy to Nimrod, the rod, the DNA, so that he could light his DNA up so that he could go interdimensionally. So they were given their energy to light his DNA up so he could reach God. He could go to the higher dimensions. You can only go to the higher dimensions when you have enough soul energy. You're not allowed in. When you die, you will go to lower dimensions. It really depends on what you've done. So Nimrod, he was going to get to God because his DNA was being lit up from all the energy that people were giving him. So that was making him multidimensional. Think about putting helium in a balloon, how it floats. It goes up. That's the same thing with DNA. It lights up. All the junk DNA, all of that was lit up a long time ago. And we know that, quote, the fall of man was a fall in frequency and vibration and so on. People walking around in society, they live on around 20 to 30% of the energy that they should have streaming through them. This keeps them asleep and in a state of almost what I call sleep and beauty state. So a lot of the world is in a sleep and beauty state. When we instill energy within our bodies, it lights the DNA up, and then we will start to activate the junk DNA. So essentially, I'm trying to instill this in people and how this works. How a lot of society are energy cattle for those who are hidden to continuously gather the energy of humanity. They keep their status and so on and so on and so on. To have riches, to have fame or whatever else, you have to have a lot of energy because you project your reality. If you're not building it up on a spiritual level, how do you think that these people are projecting their reality? They're stealing it from, quote, these sheep of society that don't know how precious their energy is. So they stay wealthy and rich, and society stays the working masses that are continuously energy cattle. The more energy that you have, the more you can project a beautiful reality. So essentially, humanity is being used this instant to project lower realities, keeps them enslaved, and it keeps the top guys, you know, they don't want humanity to know that they could change timelines, that they could change their whole world, that they could do things as, stay full of energy much longer. They used to talk about how people lived for up to 1,000 years. They had enough energy. When your body doesn't have enough energy, you age. This is the thing. When you don't have enough energy, you're sick, and so on and so on and so on. So energy heals. And in the future, we're going to see how energy, when holographic organs can be created just through energy and put in the body. And the body is a projection of your energy. So we will learn this in the future, and that will be used in the medical field. And this is what I was speaking to some of the people of the UN recently. Yesterday. So this is all the stuff of the future. The problem is that those who run this world, they are very greedy on this energy. They don't want humanity to know that their souls are so precious and divine. Now, the soul is a piece of what I call God. Or it's very hard to explain, but the soul is a piece of God. I mean, I know that even in the Bible it says that the kingdom of God is within. It's very interesting to watch people so lost, you know, looking for God everywhere else, and they don't realize that they are a piece of God. They don't realize that every time they hurt themselves, that they hurt God. And we live in a society where, you know, fast food is self-harm. It harms your body. It's a very, very, to me, evil and dark thing. So essentially, when you realize that you're a piece of God, that you're a part of God, then you can nurture that. The thing is it's about the soul. If you take out the U, you have S-O-L, which in French, of course, is sun and soleil. And it is light energy. It is a piece of light energy. I don't know if anybody's seen when people die, you know, the orbs, the little orbs that are around them or come out of them. This is the soul energy. The little orbs that come out of them are the soul energy. And I'm hopefully in the future we will use more and more tech to see these sort of things, because that sort of tech exists. So the you have like a little sun within you of soul energy. This is very, very precious. This connects you to everything. The problem is that people are born without knowing that they can build that up and put more soul energy into themselves, more light energy into themselves, and be connected back to God. I think more and more it's showing that, you know, with the aura photographs and stuff, we're seeing, oh, there's certain colors. Why is it certain people have certain colors? And they put it down to, well, they're happy, this and this and this. Originally, the auras are supposed to be multicolored or rainbow. Each color taps into each different frequency and makes you multidimensional, makes you one with God. Thing is that most people are missing a lot of colors in their aura. They're born like that, and they're born non-illuminated. So, in all of this research that I've done, essentially, I found out that people who were really, really sick, not only did they have a depletion of this soul energy, they also had sort of black or gray in their auras, and I could see links and entities. And I noticed when I started to clear them and build them back up that they started to heal, and even their attitudes and everything changed. Essentially, they were coming back closer to God, and they were realizing that they were tapping into God's source energy, because they were healing the God source energy within themselves and bringing a lot more of it back in. So you have a sun energy inside of you. This is why the Egyptians were sun worshippers. The Egyptians knew that they could build up their soul energy through the sun. They're now proving that there's rays of the sun that you cannot see. That literally, just like you can't, most people can't see their aura, there are rays of the sun that the human eyes cannot see. So it's building up the multidimensional part that you cannot see of yourself. So essentially, your body it photosynthesizes, or it's like plants. Excuse me, because I grew up in France, so some of my words are, you know, some of the English words I do not know. So it's you're like a plant. A plant, you know, it absorbs light energy. The thing is you are made up of cells. And your body can become a prison cell for your soul if you do not play this right. Essentially, these cells are, they absorb light energy. They're like solar panels. Your body's like a solar panel for light energy, including what you put in your body. If you put in, dead food, what do you think is going to happen to your body? You're going to not be feeding your soul energy, and you're going to also sort of be, you're going to get sick and everything, and this is going to block you up on a cellular level. Now, I did some research, and there's a lot of heavy metals in beauty products. There's a lot of heavy metals. There's even heavy metals, believe it or not, in fast foods. There's a lot of heavy metals in candies. And I think that nobody's really realized, why are they just putting heavy metals in these foods? Yeah, it makes you sick, but there's something else to it. There's something very spiritual about it. The metals go into your cells, which are like solar panels to absorb light energy from the sun and even emotions. Believe it or not, people, when emotions are colors that are sent to each other and their energy. I'm very strange. to a lot of people, not to myself. I remember lives on Mars, in Atlantis, Egypt, and I remember that they did not speak with words. Words were only, the voice and the chat was only used when needed to heal things. So I remember these things. I remember that when they spoke through emotions and telepathy. And that when somebody was sick, everybody else could sense that. They would send enough energy to heal that one. And that meant when they were sick, it was because something was emotionally wrong with them. So they would heal the emotions, which would then heal the body. So I remember all of these things. And it's taken me a long time to sort of put together all of this to explain it in a somewhat understandable way to a lot of groups that I speak to around the world. So your cells, essentially, are like solar panels. They absorb light energy. The heavy metals, what they do is they get into your cells and they, like mirrors, reflect out any light energy. So you, that light energy that should be literally activate, you know, feeding your chakras, feeding your aura and everything else, your soul starts to, you start to starve of light energy. What happens is that it's blocking out all the light energy. So your soul is starting to starve. And believe it or not, your soul needs to be replenished of light energy on every single level. With live food, with sun, you know, even with meditation. Meditation, and you could pull energy from the earth, from everything into you. You know that the only universal law is that you cannot take it from others unless somebody loves you and they want to give it to you willingly. So essentially, it gets these heavy metals, and this is why there's chemtrails that are full of aluminum, another heavy metal. They get into your cells, then they reflect back like mirrors. They reflect so that you cannot absorb light energy. This makes you great. This makes you so that you do not have great shields for any of the lower entities or anything. It starts, your shields start to break down, lower entities start to get in, and you start to get fed off of. So what do you think that these governments around the world are doing to their peoples? They're feeding. So they stay up on the top, the elite. They have soul deals for soul energy, and they're feeding their masses. They're feeding the masses energy to lower beings, and those lower beings leave them alone so that they can have their status and whatever else. So they basically have sold out humanity on every single level. And this is why there's a fight on consciousness through food, through chemtrails and everything else. Even beauty products, everything else. It's all chemical related so that it can get into your cells. It can break down your shields so that you are then, lower entities can come and feed on you. So when we talk about that, you know, the high magician, the high, elite are high magicians. They're high dark magicians. And they don't give a crap about humanity. They essentially see like their status and they think they're going to be okay. So essentially you have, once you realize these sort of things, you, it's this, you know, once you realize this sort of truth, you need to start to try to go ahead and understand that you're all powerful within yourself. Each one of you are divine in nature. This is what they don't want you to understand. I have a tattoo right here. It says ISIS, not for the terrorist group. Okay, so let's, so you, this goes to the God gene also. So essentially, you understand that they are trying to tear you down on a cellular level. On a cellular level, then they go after your genetics, your DNA, your cosmic antenna here. Can't stream in, it starts to break down, can't stream in the energy that it should. You start to age, you start to get sick, you start to get depressed and everything else. And entities, you know what? Entities love when people are sad and down and sick and depressed because they let out energy and then they can feed. They're already in their shields and they can feed. So then they feed off of them and feed off of them until basically the person gets very sick and they die or so on and so on. You know all those homeless out there? They're used for energy. They're energy cattle. There, a lot of them have been used for energy and they are simply being thrown away like that. This is why the government has such a vendetta against the homeless. They've basically been fed to the lower entities. They're just depleted of energy. We need to get rid of them now because they're just basically body bags with very little energy and the entities don't want them anymore. They want new crops. So they have to clear out the old crops. So this is something that they do. So to go back to the ISIS tattoo, okay, we know that the book of Genesis, the Bible is encoded, every divine book is encoded, every religious book is encoded with divine things, but it's also sort of a maze. It's interesting how it's, if you are illuminator, you have your third eye open, and if you are more multidimensional, you will understand what's in there that is real and what's in there is lies, because there is, it's mixed all around. So we go to the book of Genesis. I have the Isis, gene Isis, DNA Isis. God said, I am that I am. Has anybody done any research on the God gene? Okay, the God gene, I am that I am, Isis, gene, Isis, gene I am, DNA I am that I am. The book of Genesis is about light in the God gene so that you do not be bestial, because bestial is the lower chakras, which is basically about eat, mate, and lower sort of emotions. The whole book of Genesis was about lighten the God gene up so that humanity became no longer bestial, but rather became multidimensional. This is what the book of Genesis is encoded as, the God gene, gene Isis, gene I am that I am. So they don't want you to have your God gene lit up. They want your DNA, which is your DNA, to be broken down. They want you to be depleted of energy, and they want you to rot away, and essentially they can get rid of you for new crops of people. So there's a huge war on consciousness, and there's a war for soul energy going on right now. This is a huge problem around the world. All those children starve, and where do you think all that energy is going? Once in New York, I lived in New York years and years ago, and I wanted to go and help the children that were starving overseas, specific part of Africa. So I'm very good at astral projection. I have all these experiences where I have to help out humanity. This is one of the things that I always like to joke about. If I've got a sort of a contract that I have to be here on Earth. And it's probably, I love it here, but where I come from, it's very angelic or highly evolved, and I remember this, and sometimes on Earth it can be a bit hard. So I said, you know, I went in deep meditation, and I was living in New York back then. So I said, I'm going to try to go free, you know, go free the children over there that are starving so that they can have some meat. So I got over, I'm able to astral project. I don't know if any of you in here know what astral projection is. I get out of my body. And I go interdimensionally. So I projected myself over Africa. So I was in the clouds, and there was a sort of thunder going on and storm going on. And I could see this black cloud over, and it was all the children when they were suffering. All that energy was being absorbed. All those starving children, it was being absorbed by this massive entity that feeds off of energy. And it was a very powerful entity. It knocked me flat, and I'm very good at astral projection. I realized that, you know, that essentially this entity, it was one of the ones that was helping hold those of power in order, and, you know, it gets to feed off of that part of the world. It gets to feed off of all those children, all that energy. So there's a lot of this around. The desert. The earth used to be lush before, everywhere. There was no desert. The earth, the parts that have been really drained of energy by these entities, it's become desert. So that's another thing. And I'm trying to keep in line here because I am very tired. I haven't had food in the last, I've had probably 2-3 hours sleep, if that, for the last couple of days each night. To go back. These entities don't want you to know they exist, these lower entities, and they want you to continuously watch TV, because every time you focus on something, that's where you're given energy. A TV is exactly like where you sit down and worship. Would you sit down at an altar and worship, you know, concentrate. A TV is based off of the same idea. And what your eyes are the windows to your soul. Everybody knows that one. Your soul energy. So when you're focused and all the drama plays your emotions up and down, emotions are energy. Every time your emotions are played and you're watching a series and you think, oh my God, that person died, and you feel those emotions, that's all being leached from you. It's all being, and it's been put to humanity as normal. A lot of things, as going to get fast food, it's been put to humanity as normal to eating food that is very bad for you. Again, we're going to go back that when somebody's lit up and they have charged themselves with enough energy, their aura and everything is multicolored. In the Bible, there's a verse that says that the angels' coats were multicolored. We remember the story of Joseph, where he had a coat of many colors, so he was beloved by God. And his brothers ripped his coat. They stole his energy. It was not a literal coat. And it says, there's a verse in the Bible that says that the angels had a multicolored a robe, and they walked among the stones of fire, which were the planets. They were interdimensional because of that. people in society, they don't want people to become interdimensional, because guess what? Then they realize that there's all this other stuff that exists. You can go among the stars. I've flown among the stars and everything. Being multidimensional is absolutely beautiful. You're not scared to die. You know, it's like, you know, you watch all these fantasy movies or you watch all these things to try to get this, like, you know, these experiences, when you can go experience them yourself. There's massive amounts of creation, massive amounts of dimensions, and massive amounts of experiences that you can go and, you know, go in and out. The whole system here on Earth was set to keep everybody in. It happened a long time ago, the fallen frequency or fallen vibration of man. So essentially, man was able to walk with God. We read this in many, many religions. It's quite well known in many depictions around the world. They fell from that. They fell in energy. And as they fell in energy, their frequency went down and they got cut off from walking with God. And all the relics, the pyramids, the Stonehenge, all around the world, you know, the face on Mars, all of these things are ancient technology of before when man had fallen, before man had fallen. And all of these, all of this technology was also from some other beings that are very, very evolved beings. They had interacted with man back then. And there is proof, you know, I remember Mars and how there were wars on Mars. And I was working the other day with my friend. He goes, you know, it's funny because there's a whole bunch of craters on the moon, like there was a great war, but we don't see any meteorites or asteroids hitting the moon. Why is it all these years nobody's caught anything hitting the moon, but it looks like it's been battered, literally, the moon. It's caught all these, and a lot of these planets do. And, okay, so I remember Mars being inhabited and a lot of the planets being inhabited, and there was a system where there was pyramids that were all interlocking, and people used to teleport from one planet to another, and everything was very, you know, they used to speak, like I said, through emotions and through colors and things like that, rather through the voice, because that was a lower thing. So I remember this, and I remember that this technology was also set up by some of the higher beings. For if anything ever happened, then, you know, we would sort of be locked in here until people started waking up to their own souls. So all of this technology, essentially, you hear about a whole bunch of things about the moon, and I don't know if anybody in here, like, researches this stuff, but there's a lot of people say, well, the moon recycles souls, it pushes souls back. So essentially, since I can get out of my body, and I work very hard at being multidimensional, and trust me, once I lost a lot of energy. I was trying to help somebody else out, and I gave them a lot of energy, and I got cut off a bit, because the energy is what makes you multidimensional. And, you know, so essentially, I got locked out a bit, and that once, and that quite was quite hurtful, and I had to work at getting back there. The planets and everything, everybody was able to teleport, and they were able to travel among the stars and, you know, interact with other higher beings and so on and so on. Then everybody was sort of locked in here once wars happened a long time ago, and that's where I do not remember that one part of how the wars happened. I just remember is that everybody has shields around them. They have these shields, and like I said, when it shuts down, lower entities can come in, and so do planets. In fact, scientists just proved there's some sort of shield around this planet. They don't know where it's come from. They've just figured this out not long ago. It was in Science Magazine. You can look it up. Well, there was shields around Mars and everything like that. There was also what I call the Ark planet. That's where DNA from different species were put onto one planet in case there was wars, because there was always backup plans. And that was Earth. So this is why a lot of animals and stuff like that, they're very ancient DNA that come from other planets. There's a lot of people. Sometimes you'll recognize somebody, you'll think they look elven, or they look like dwarf maybe, or they look maybe like a bit like mermaid, or this, or this, or this. It's because all that DNA was put here, and then a program was run where everybody had to be a bit more the, you know, in bodies and get along, because there were different races, and a long time ago, they broke out and they warred among each other, like little children. And they didn't realize, because they were so high frequency, that the issues it would cause them. So I remember living on Mars, and I remember that there was a war on Mars, that there was a nuclear war on Mars. I remember this, and I remember it destroyed everybody within the 1 day's time of Earth time. I remember the shield, somehow the shield of Mars, somehow it broke down, and then all these lower forces from lower realms came and, you know, sort of destroyed everything and sucked so much energy out of that planet, it shut the core down. I see the same thing happening to Earth. I see so much energy being leached from Earth by these lower entities and lower energies that it's shutting it down, and humanity doesn't, they're asleep. They don't know that their own planet is dying right now. But they have the power. What I want to let them know is that they have the power to heal it. And it's instilled with them, it's instilled within them, within their very voices and within their energy. So essentially seeing that coming to Earth, incarnating on Earth, that was my sole mission, to try to remind people that, you know, somehow I had remembered these things, and, you know, I don't want that to happen to Earth. A year after, on my video blog, I did a video blog talking about how Mars was destroyed by nuclear wars, and a year after that, scientists came out and said that they think that Mars had nuclear wars, that they had found evidence. It was very nice to see that. It was also very nice to see that they found some evidence of nuclear stuff in the desert that's ages, hundreds and hundreds of years old, of when nuclear didn't, quote, exist. So it's very interesting that they're finding that stuff. And they will be more and more and more. And then we have the government that's trying to figure out what's happening with the pyramids and Stonehenge. I know, because I was at the Stonehenge, by the way, when you're interdimensional, you go all to these other places, and time seems to be just a bit, I don't live in time, it's very hard to keep track of mine. So this is a couple of years ago, I was asked at the Stonehenge to go ahead and, you know, see what was happening with the mounds around the Stonehenge, and there was some Russian scientists there, and I decided not to tell them very much of anything, but anyhow, I went ahead and I got out of my body and went to the mound and went to inner earth, to that dimension. Yes, inner earth exists, and you can go to inner earth. You build up your soul energy, and you'll have a lot of great adventures, by the way. But that's all shut off to, you know, these governmental people, because they don't understand how the soul works. See, at all. They don't understand how divine the soul is, and they just think they can exploit it for energy, and they don't know how divine the soul works. So it was a very nice thing at Stonehenge, the mounds around it, to go in, and they teleport you to inner earth. There's all of this ancient tech that's left, and when the wars happened, it's a matrix system, and everybody probably knows in this room about the matrix system and how it locks people in, and they think, oh, we're a prisoner in this own system, it's horrible. You're a prisoner in this system until you light yourselves up, until you stop being children and you become you stop being co-pilots, but you become pilots of yourselves, of your souls and your body. And then you will become pilots of your reality, and you will become pilots of this earth that's been given to you by God. And then the elite that are dark magicians that hold power, they will not have power anymore. But it will only happen as each one of you lights yourselves up on these levels. This is, for me, the message that I'm trying to bring across to people on every single level. So the whole, quote, matrix system, yes, it keeps doing. So my experience with the moon is when I had enough energy. So I was like, well, I'm going to go all the way up to Saturn, because a long time ago, I remember during the wars, that Saturn had, there was a machine on Saturn that helps project time. That's the rings around Saturn project different realities in time. This is all like a cosmic machine. So I thought, I'm going to go there. The temple that projects time. That's what I call Saturn. So I decided to go Saturn. I was like, I got this energy, I can fly among the stars, I'm gonna use it to go to Saturn. So I got to the moon, and I had a very interesting experience with the moon, talking about the matrix system. I get to the moon, and I'm projecting to the moon, and I'm trying to get past the moon, and there's the dark side of the moon, and I don't know if anybody's seen the Pink Floyd cover of the Dark Side of the Moon, where they have these little pyramids, and then they have the rainbow. Yes, the rainbow. Okay, and what is your soul again? It's rainbow colored. It's the colors. Yes. So, Pink Floyd definitely know are great magicians. They know their stuff, because I can tell you this is what I experienced. So I'm trying to fly out, and suddenly the moon, I start to get sucked to the moon. My soul self started to get sucked to the moon. The dark side of the moon, there are thousands of small pyramids, and any soul that's trying to get out of here, it sucks them back and it throws them back here on Earth. That means the remaining piece of energy, it seeds you into a body again, grows you like a plant, and sucks back off of you. So you are in a, over and over and over again, you're caught in a thing. This is the thing though, is that, so I realized that the moon is part of the matrix system. It pushes people back down. So then I thought, okay, so God loves people. Why would God lock them in? I remember the wars. I thought, why would God lock them in? Of course, I call God a force, a divine force that our souls are part of. This is how I believe in God. I do not believe in God as a little man sitting up there in heaven. Sorry, these are not my beliefs at all. I believe in God as a male and female force, and as a force that's also just a very powerful force of good, that's omnipresent, omnipotent. They just found scrolls that were said that they just found scrolls that are part of the biblical scrolls that say God is a female and male force. Of course, this is very, very true. It's feminine and it's male and female. So, you know, and a lot of religious people don't want to accept that, but this is the truth. It is the truth. God is not a potent, beautiful creation that pushes one down and pulls the other up. That is not God. God's source is very fair to everything. I mean, I think that on earth we think that God is unfair because people are dying, children are starving, stuff like that. But unless you will not become pilots of yourself if you are not put under pressure. A diamond does not become a diamond until it's put under pressure. And you cannot, how would you want to, you know, God offers all of these things to humanity. When everybody lights up, there will be no starvation. There will be nothing that is horrible on earth ever, ever again. There will be a long amount of peace. And I've seen this as sort of golden age. And I think that is promised to humanity on every single level, as long as they go ahead and they do their part and they light themselves up. And they start to care about their souls and their bodies. And they start to cultivate themselves rather than tear themselves down every single day through food and everything else. So I was like, okay, so we have this matrix system here, and exactly why is it set up here? Then I realized that a long time ago, everybody started arguing like little children on some level, and there was wars, and it's locking everybody in here. But at the same time, I realized something else. I was accessing this stuff, and I was being let out, and it was actually being helpful to me. So I realized that when you light yourself up, all that ancient technology, it's a gift to humanity. It's a gift from what you call the angels or high beings that are sort of what I call liquid energy that had interacted with humanity back then. So when you light yourselves up, all that stuff is going to help humanity out. It's going to help heal them on every single level. So it will no longer be negative. As in keep it, yes, it's going to keep you in here. If you do not connect with yourself, you do not build yourself up, you're going to be quarantined. Imagine how many people on earth have entities, have a lot less soul energy than they should, and are very sick on a soul energy level. On a soul level, a lot of people are sick on earth. So they're quarantined here because of that. They're quarantined until they realize that they're divine and they build themselves up. Because we live in societies that are very self-destructive. You know, it's interesting how self-destructiveness is being self-destructive seems so common. Oh yes, teens get on drugs. That's just a normal phase. You know, they eat a lot of fast food. That's just a normal phase. To party out all their soul energy, that's just a normal, all these things seem so normal. Being destructive to ourselves seems so normal in society. And I think there's Antoine Levain, he said, most of society is already satanic anyhow. And what is, he was right when he said that, Antoine Levain. Everybody is abusing themselves, abusing their souls, and abusing people around them. And it's something normal. It's something common to everybody. It's taught as something common. So they don't know. Nobody knows better. They think it's okay to do so. It's okay to go through a phase in your teens of drugs. That messes up your DNA. Certain stuff messes up your DNA. And people don't realize this. So Antoine Levain had a very good point. Also service to others and service to self. Everybody is living in a service to self. Society. They are not living in service to others' society. Essentially, he was really quite on point with that. The thing is that we have issues right now. We have Fukushima. We have a lot of issues right now with the Earth. And the Earth, it's what keeps everybody alive and well, you know? Recently, I was in LA, and I was You know, and it's funny because as I went towards LA, I saw the same sort of entity just feeding off of all of the energy in LA. So it was just like this black cloud over LA. And LA is very lovely, and a lot of people are very nice to me there, and I have a lot of friends there that are amazing, you know, that help out with homeless and stuff. But LA has got this dark cloud of energy over it that sucks again energy from the people. Because imagine how many people are trying to be rich and famous in LA, and how many people are suffering because they're not getting anywhere in LA. Essentially, that's happening. So I went to the beach there, and I could feel the ocean. I tapped right into the ocean. And when you are multidimensional, you will tap into animals and you will tap into the ocean and everything else. And then you are asked, because, well, you're a pilot now, you're not a co-pilot, you're asked to find solution. And you have those solutions within yourself because you're divine. So I tapped into the ocean, and the ocean was, she was like a woman that was very sad and crying and sick. She was like a woman who was nearly dying. And the ocean started speaking to me, and she said to me, she says that she's hurting, and I could feel it, and I cried. I literally should have been very happy at my friend's bonfire, you know, and they are wondering what's happening to me, because I'm sitting on the beach crying like a baby for like 3 hours, and they didn't know what to do, because I could feel the emotion from the ocean. Literally everything on the earth has emotions. The trees, plants, animals, oceans, they have emotions. She started speaking to me, and I cried. When I cried and did that, I let out some of the emotional stuff that she had. When I go to heal a person, I connect to them, and they have, let's say their heart hurts, I can feel that, and I let that out, and their heart heals. That's how I do it. So I do this to help out the planet too. If more people were lit up, we wouldn't have this sort of issue. We wouldn't have any issues on. We wouldn't have starvation or anything. Essentially, I was speaking to the ocean, and I know this might sound a bit strange to a few of you, but this is how I live. And it doesn't matter, because it's between me and God, and I do not care what humanity thinks, because until they awaken, you know, I don't have to care. It's between me and God. So essentially, the ocean, she starts to tell me that she's dying. She's telling me she's dying. And over the, you know, you can research this, the ocean is dying right now from Fukushima. This is, remember what I said about Mars, what destroyed Mars? Nuclear. Nuclear destroys Mars. Do you know why? Okay, nuclear is the only energy that pierces the dimensions and creates holes to lower dimensions. It creates holes to lower dimensions, and when it does, it allows negative entities in. So they pour nuclear directly into our oceans and everything for the dark beings to be let out of the lower realms. Nuclear, this is why there's a lot of UFOs seen around nuclear power plants. There's a lot of issues with nuclear power plants because the higher-ups do not want nuclear wars to happen here again on Earth like they happened on Mars, and it literally pierced the dimensions. There's lower stuff in the lower dimensions that chose not to evolve like everybody else and everything else, so it was locked away in lower dimensions. Nuclear is great. They pour it in the water. It's put in the water, and it pierces the lower dimensions, which allows negative entities to come through there. So it's really, when these nuclear things happen, a lot of them are done purposely, whether you believe it or not. It is not by accident. They're just worshiping their lower beings that are keeping them in power. So by being destructive, Thurf, what does self-destructive make you? Being self-destructive allows entities to come into you. Being destructive to the earth allows more entities to come into lower dimensions onto the earth realm, and also leech off the earth. That is energy, because she's the life of the earth. And it's all a huge thing of feeding these entities energy so that they can go ahead and keep their power, the high black magicians. So I was speaking to the ocean, and she says to me, she goes, you know, she goes, please tell humanity something for me. She says, please tell humanity that each one of them has the power to heal me. She said, within the voice, that there are, by chanting, if people gathered along the ocean would chant, the frequency, the vibrations from the voice would actually clear and heal the ocean, and it would heal the life in the ocean. This is instilled within you. When you speak, when you put your will, and when you become multidimensional, you become ultra powerful. This is why Jesus in the Bible said, you will do greater works than I. And Jesus would control the weather and stuff. Why isn't it Okay, so Jesus said you will do greater works than I. Why aren't people controlling the weather or doing things like that? Why aren't people just healing like Jesus did? Isn't something wrong there? I don't see these sort of miracles happening. I see once in a great while. But Jesus said you will do more. Jesus was multidimensional. Basically, Jesus was a multidimensional being, and he had all of that lit up. And he was trying to teach humanity back then how you could do these sort of things. A lot of the stuff, the parables and everything, are encoded with these sort of things. Jesus hated religion back then. Now we have religions about Jesus. Jesus hated religion back then. Hated temples. Jesus said that the temples within hated the temples, but we have all these, quote, temples around everywhere. We have more starving children in the United States than in some of the other countries in the world, believe it or not. I know because I work with a lot of homeless kids and a lot of homeless people, but we have so many places of worship. And guess what? All these places of worship, people forgot that they're divine, and they're looking for God in the wrong spot. They're looking for God in places and in books. They're not looking for God in the right spot, which is within themselves. They can't believe that they might be just that amazing, that God loved them that much, that God made them a part of itself. So essentially, everybody is, it's like the greyhound dog that's running, chasing the plastic rabbit he's never going to get. Until the end of the race, that's what they are doing with God. And, you know, it's funny because of the fact that, for me, religion is a tool of, and I don't know if there's any religious in here, I don't want to offend you, because I'm sorry if I do. Yes. The word religion, by the way. Okay, so all these people worshiping in religions too, guess who they're giving their energy to? Lower entities. Again, keeping them shut down again. So there's this whole thing there. If they're getting you through food, through chemtrails, they're getting you through all of these different things, religion and stuff like that. There's a lot of different points in this game that's going on. Essentially, the word religion is very interesting because I don't know if anybody's watched the movie They Live. Has anybody seen this movie called They Live? Yes, there you go. How there's words within words encoded. Yes. Okay, so I, you know, being multidimensional, I can see that. When I look at words and stuff, I can even see people who are not people and stuff like that. I can see people whose souls are so withered and things like that. I can see people who have entities in them. A lot and lot of entities. But anyhow, to go back to that, and They Live, the words change. That means, you know, he'd see billboards and it changed to say obey or this, very negative things. Well, essentially, in the word religion, you have rely on jinn. Does anybody know what the jinn are? Jinn are demons in Islam. So what are you relying on to get to heaven, religion? You're relying on demons. So this is a joke to humanity. They think they're going to go to heaven through religion, and actually they're just giving their soul energy to lower entities. And they like, and I noticed that the dark ones, they like parading what they're doing in front of humanity. Because in the Bible it says that the devil has to tell you what the devil is doing. Now the word devil, again, let's go back to the word devil. The word devil does not mean devil as in a single being. D in French means of, so you got vile. Those the group that is saying those that are vile. The word devil means those that are vile. So it doesn't mean one being, it means those that are vile. So you're giving your energy to those that are vile through religion. Demons, or whatever you want to call them. Again, so, and I'm here, let me go ahead and look at my chart here, because I'm trying not to get off track, and I'm trying to go on and on and on here. So we've got angels. Okay, so a lot of technology from a long time ago was when man interacted with higher beings, and this technology was given to them, and it will be reactivated when you reactivate yourself through, like I said, energy. And again, I'll have to explain that one after. Yes, ETs do exist. There are different forms of creation. Creation is, I mean, I it's funny because somebody was talking to me about time the other day, and when I get out of my body, time does not exist. Time does only exist is in this realm. Time does not exist in other realms. There's so much creation that it's quite beautiful. A lot of it is very, very beautiful creation. And it's interacting with humanity, but it's waiting for them to become, they get a glimpse of these things. They know something's there. So you see UFOs, you see evidence of angels, you see ghosts, evidence of ghosts and stuff like that. They get little glimpses. But if you became multidimensional, you talk to it all the time and you'd interact with it all the time. It's quite lovely. I interact with ghosts and things like that. And I'll have to explain something about ghosts because I was requested by those who, and I work with a lot that have passed, people that have passed ghosts. I was requested by them, the souls of the loved ones, of everybody's loved ones that have passed, to let you know that they are there. And that when they pass, instead of being really, really sad about, you need to light candles and you need to send them energy so that they can use that energy to pass to the higher realms. Otherwise, they get stuck. A lot of ghosts are stuck in these realms. I go to haunted houses and they're like, you know, these poor ghosts are on expo of how they're upset and angry. They're stuck in this realm. They don't have enough light energy to get and move on. So they're stuck and they're angry and upset. Imagine being stuck there for what, 60, 70 years, if not 100 years or more. They want to move on. The old Celtic, in the Celtic culture, if I remember, they would bring things, you know, and that would give them energy and light candles and stuff like that and chant and sing. That would give them energy. This, through the sound, it pierces all dimensions again. It would give them energy so they can move on. So imagine how many loved ones are caught without being able to move on, and then entities leech from them when they get out of this body, because there's so many, there's a web of catching soul energy and souls in this world. So ETs exist. I often interact with ETs. They are very much higher ETs that... okay, so this is what I'm going to explain about ETs. ETs are not, they're not solid like you think that these, like these objects. They're not like this. They're energy. When the ET crashes, it's because the magnetic field of the Earth is much more dense, and it sucked them down. As it sucked them down, they become more dense, and when they get really dense, they can't control themselves, and they can't control their craft, and that's when they crash. They're not used to being in dense places like Earth, so they get into some trouble then. And the government knows this, and the government also knows that using sound technology and light technology, they can battle higher beings and ETs. And they also know that using light and sound, every day you guys have light and sound technology that's used, not positive, light and sound technology that's used on you to suppress you. And it's done through cell phone towers and everything else. The world has basically become a web of where there's so many sounds that you cannot hear that are there, by the way, that are keeping your consciousness down. Because imagine that you're a weave of energy, which is energy has a tune to it. You're a symphony. Imagine that you're being the waves they're sending to you is also sound, but it's a lower dense sound, and it's messing up your symphony. Now, I will give you one example of this. When I was in England, because I've lived in England for 3 years, and I was, you know, I was right on the shore. I spoke to some whales. Some sperm whales. Now, I went to a state, I got out of my body again, and I was pulled to depths of the ocean, and the sperm whales, they were saying, this group was saying, they were gonna beach themselves. So they told me they were gonna beach themselves. And I was trying desperately to tell them not to do this. And essentially, they said, for 1 minute, they were very angry, and they said they'd prefer to die. And I was saying, listen, you know, please don't do this. So speaking with them, and then the whale said to me, the main one, the pack leader, there was the one that was, he was a more elder of their pack. He sort of said to me, he said, I want you to feel what I feel. And immediately, I got to feel what the whales feel. And I know why whales are beaching themselves, and dolphins and stuff like that. It sounded like heavy metal music down there. They communicate through sonar and stuff through sound. Well, all the Wi-Fi and satellites, it's going directly into the water, and it's making it like 1,000 times more down there, because water. And so it's like heavy metal music at the top of what you can play it 24 hours a day in their ears, in their heads. That's why they're beaching themselves. So the ocean is basically, it's all of this technology, which is this technology that's been given to us here, this is not the original technology meant for humanity. Original technology is built in your DNA because you're divine. You are to speak telepathically and stuff, not originally on cell phones, but there are lower dimensional entities that have this technology, and they gave this technology to humanity. They gave it to humanity and tricked them a bit. And eventually, the real technology, which is within your DNA, because your divine will be given to you and you will understand it as you awaken it, and that's the truth. This technology is very dangerous for the world. And I know we consider it very advanced, but where I come from, this technology is not very advanced. It's only the lower creatures from 1D, 2D, and from the lower realms that use technology. And it's messing up the earth. It's creating so the animals are going crazy, specifically in our oceans. It is creating that the whales and stuff are beaching themselves because they can't stand listening to all of the incoming frequencies from all the satellites and all the Wi-Fi and everything around the world that gets pushed to the ocean. It's basically bouncing off down there. So essentially, sound. ETs are a bit the same. They communicate through sound and stuff like that. And when they get wrecked here, it's because they've become more dense. Am I not? Okay, so I've spoken how DNA is your cosmic energy antenna. So a lot of people I notice in society, and I'm already gonna go over this again a bit. A lot of people I notice in society, their DNA is broken. Okay, Jacob's ladder to heaven. Does anybody remember the story of Jacob's ladder to heaven where he climbs the angel, where the angels are? The ladder's the DNA. Jacob had, he was multidimensional. That's why God loved him. He was multidimensional because he had his DNA lit up. So he could walk where the angels did. So it's all encoded. So, by the way, a good exercise to light your DNA up, and of course, you're going to have, there's a lot of things. You have to chelate because you have to get the metals out of your body. You have to get out of the city and get around plants because they will willingly, the earth will willingly give you energy to uplift you. Then there's a whole series of things I will explain at the end of how to do this. But a very good thing is to imagine a gold spiral ladder. And then imagine the top of it becomes sort of like a flower of life and spin it. And you do that every day before you go to bed a couple of minutes, and that will help activate your DNA. Because inside of you have and if you're sick, you have the willpower to tell yourself that you won't be sick. And that's within you, you can do that, and your body will listen to you. And this is why in commercials, by the way, this is why in commercials they repeat usually three times or do flashes, because the subconscious mind recognizes it after three times or three flashes. And it's really interesting how people respond to light flashes, and how, just something really interesting I noticed is that where I'd stop at a stoplight, and it would sort of make me where I just zoned out after the three flashing lights. And then eventually I was with my friend and they showed me Fringe. And when they were to mess with the mind in there, they flashed lights three times. And I noticed in subliminal programming for the mind to pick up something, it does three times. And in songs, a lot of songs are about broken hearts, because again, there's as much as there is a war on the DNA, there's a war on cosmic consciousness. There's a war on the heart. There's a war on your soul. There's a war on your heart. Because the heart gives out pulses of a lot of energy. And this is the only thing that they cannot overcome is the heart. So they want to shut it down on every single level. So there's a massive amounts of songs about broken hearts. Well, they repeat over and over in the song about broken hearts. Notice there isn't really about a lot of songs about I'm in love and I'm happy. There's a lot of songs about I'm in a broken heart and I'm suffering. And over the broken heart. So and guess what? Then your subconscious registers broken heart over and over again. And that affects your literal energy body of your literal energetic body of your heart. And then you start to think, well, I need to have a broken, literally this is how it does. You start to think, I need to have a broken heart. The body starts to think, I'm getting commanded to have a broken heart. Literally, so it does that. So you will have, it can even give heart issues. I was speaking to my aunt's acupuncturist, who was speaking to me about this, that somebody wore a t-shirt with that said something, and literally, and I noticed that in t-shirts too, a lot of negative stuff in t-shirts. And it imprinted onto the person, and when they stopped wearing that t-shirt, their health problems went away. So I noticed there's a lot of t-shirts that have very horrible sayings on it. And I was doing some work with somebody close to me, and they every time they put this t-shirt on that had this weird frequency thing, like erratic frequency thing, they would not be well. They would say, I didn't feel well. When I was working with them, I realized it was the t-shirt. And when I made them remove the t-shirt, they didn't have any problems. The body was imprint in the t-shirt's, the literal, yes, message. Okay, so I spoke about soul energy and the God gene and how we can light that up and how the whole I am. So we went over that. The dimensions, okay. So has anybody seen the whole Earth is flat thing? Everybody, I do a lot of work in alternative media, and that's the whole, there's a lot of thing going around, a lot of stuff about the Earth is flat going around right now, which is a very interesting thing. So the dimensions are in layers. Think about a layered cake. The dimensions are in layers. So the whole thing with the Earth is flat is people are registering that we're in a layer. So they think it's flat. It's not that. It's the frequencies are like in layers. There's the lower layers, the lower realms, and then so on. You have so on and so on and so on. And it, when you, you're the spiral staircase is what I call the DNA spiral golden ladder. There's a couple of names that I call it. That makes you access up and down, either dimensions that you want. Of course, I always recommend to go to higher ones. Lower ones, probably not the greatest ones to go to, but sometimes we have to go to them for experience. Okay, ancient technologies, technology in your DNA, and the technology around the world that was left here for when humanity lights themselves up. Okay, so I think I went through most of my subjects that I kind of scribbled down there. I didn't have much time. Like I said, I almost didn't make it here, and you guys almost didn't see me this evening. So there's a couple of things that I want to go into. I want to go into sugar, how sugar is very bad to you on every single level. Okay, yes. Interestingly enough, sugar cane. Now, cane and then Nimrod, cane, the DNA. Sugar lights basically is one of the greatest things to tear down DNA, believe it or not. So sugar cane, and in French, guerre means war. It's war against the cane, the DNA. It's literally encoded in the name. Sugar is very, very bad for you on every single level. And I put some of this stuff together to try to explain to people how that it acidifies the body. And in it's funny because lower realm stuff is acidic. Now, you think about the movie Alien. What does Alien, when he throws spit, isn't he acidic when it burns people? So they're telling us it's encoded in here. For a body to be infested, it has to be acidic. And entities from the lower realm are acidic. And sugar cane destroys your DNA, your cane, your rod. It's warned against it, and it's funny because the word sugar, suger, means under war against the DNA, or the rod, the cane. So it's literally encoded in the word of how sugar is being used to on a battle of consciousness. So essentially it starts to acidify the body, and it's as it acidifies the body, that again affects you energetically. Acidified body affects you on every single level, and it allows for entities to come into you. And everybody who has entities, if we tested them, they have, anybody who has issues with having sort of personality issues, anger, stuff like that, will all have some sort of entity attachments. And I'm sure if we test them, they will be acidic. So yes. So then essentially the entity gets into you. It then hacks your third eye. And it starts to create your reality, because your reality is imagine this is the projection here. You know, we got the projection here. It's being projected. Imagine that this projects your reality. The entity is in you. He can't project you a nice reality. If he projected you a nice reality, he wouldn't be needed, and you would just, your chakras and aura and everything would build up, and it would throw him out. It would say bye to him. So no, he needs you to project. He can't project his own reality. You have to remember that. He had to get in through the back doors into you anyhow, with the help, of course, the elite that know all of these things. Essentially, the entities to get into, once they get into you, that they go for the third eye. To hack the third eye, of course, we say know that the third eye is connected to the heart. And now we know also that the gut system is connected to the brain and then to emotions. And they're saying about how parasites now affect moods. Now, this is very interesting. Let me put this down here for a second. essentially, and if my time goes over, guys, just go ahead and wave to me, please. Thank you.
You're not over, but you're right at time for questions.
I will do that in a couple of minutes. This is one interesting last thing that I have to explain. So essentially, the entity, he hacks the third, it hacks the third eye, and it starts to project to you. You can't find a job that you want. You have issues going around. You have all sorts of issues happening in your life, one after another. You're like, what is wrong? Something's wrong with me. I live a horrible life. Something's awfully wrong with me. It's not you. It's the entity. Those entities are projecting your reality. And every time you're upset and whatever, you let out energy. He's able to feed. Every time you are upset and everything else, angered or whatever, he's able to feed. And then, oh, guess what? He can feed off your family members too and everything like that, because then you become aggravated. He makes you aggravated and you start to get mad at them and they let off energy and so on and so on and so on. So then we have this sort of virus going around. Interesting thing in the Bible about the fall of man and the serpent. Okay, so I'm going to explain to you this before I do question and answer, and I'll try to hurry up on this because it's a quite deep subject. So, the serpent. Okay, first of all, the serpent is a parasite in the gut system. Parasites are connected to entities. Entities, people who have parasites have entities, vice versa. I've noticed this. So it's the literal way of connecting into this reality, into the body parasites. So the snake in the Bible, if you research rather than reading the King James Version here in the Bible or whatever else version you have, I'd say, so in England, I have a Bible that's over 100 years old. It's about this thick. And if you read it, and it's not the version of here. In fact, it's a lot more in depth on stuff. And you would, when you read that side by side, you're like, what's the King James Version? And it's absolutely beautiful. So I have a Bible that is that. Maybe sometime when I come back from England, I can come and present that Bible, because it's very interesting to do the side by side. It's almost like doing ketchup in Europe that has 5 ingredients, sugar, water, and ketchup in the United States that has 30 ingredients by the same brand, because they know that in Europe, some European countries are not allowing stuff like, you know, the fast food stuff to go in. Over in England, fast food is free-range chicken and stuff like that. I was saying, and it's very funny because it's a bit more healthy, the fast food, and by the same companies. This is how much they're playing out. Where they can get in, they're going to get into. They're going to try to get into, and they're not able to get into some countries in Europe. So they're very unhappy about this, and they have to stick with the good ingredients. They can't put any crappy ingredients like they're getting away here in the United States with. So, okay, the serpent, it has to do with parasites in the gut system. Parasites connected in your gut system. You're, of course, again, the whole articles that have just come out saying the gut system is connected to the mind, the brain, and again, the projection of reality. We can put all these things together. So by clearing yourself of parasites, your frequency will go up. Most people don't look into these things. So essentially, if you go into the old text, and you go into Gnostic texts, the snake in the Bible that crawled up the tree was a parasite. The tree, the spine, that's the tree. The top of the tree of life, all of the nerves and everything, this is the top of the tree of life, this is the bottom of the tree of life. The snake, the parasite that crawled up the tree. And see, your spine, remember what I said, that each dimension is in layers? Think about your spine. It's layer to your spine. When you're cleared out, you're activated, you're multidimensional. The whole, literally, it's connected to the spine. So essentially, the parasites get in your system and they shut you down to make you become non-multidimensional. And all these kids around the world have been born, quote, with the sins of their fathers. What are the sins of their fathers? They're born with these parasites already inside them. Their system inside their blood and everything that are affecting them, which are creating the realities, which are connected to entities. So this is a multi-layered thing. Essentially, if you clear yourself out, then, you know, and you clear your kids out, your life is going to get really, really good. I'm not kidding you. You're going to be able to project a really good reality. But you'll also have to be careful, because when you light up, there's going to be a lot of tests, because there's a lot of non-lit people up, and some of them you might think they're friends and family and they do love you, but it's the entities that are controlling them. So basically, I wanted to explain how we have the tree of life within ourselves. literal tree of life, and the parasite is the snake that crawled up the tree is within the gut system. Now it says that it will be, the snake will be stomped with a heel. Now if you look at Chinese medicine, you see that within the foot, there's the whole system, including the intestines, right here in the part of the heel. So when we'll stomp, there we go. And what you do in Chinese medicine, the whole reflexology, or where they touch there to release, there we go. So it's explaining how there's literal parasites tied to entities that cause for man to be on multidimensional. So I wanted to finish off with that, and hopefully I was able to, I wasn't able to write a lot of things down and I didn't have time to. Hopefully that did explain a lot of stuff and I was able to put it in an understandable way. And now I will do questions and answers.
To the goddess Selene, right?
The moon goddess, is that what you're talking about? Yes, and it's funny because what was just at the Oscars, it was a, what was it, moonlight or something? Yes, there we go. So, again, you have to think that each one of these planets and everything are large consciousness. So they would be considered gods or goddesses or deities or things like that. And you know, it's funny because in the Bible, there's this little nice verse that says that the gods come down among humanity and walk as humans. By the way, I was reading that the other day. I was like, very interesting verse right there. So basically, the moon is not negative. She's just, you might say that she's just, she's waiting for humanity to light up too. She's being nurturing with her light, and she's waiting for humanity to be lit up too. As humanity lights up, they'll free the planets, they'll free everything around, and she will go back to her original state, which was one of helping humanity out. It's not, it's really up to humanity. A lot of these things, even the Earth, she's dying, you know, she's trying to do what she can for humanity, but it's up to humanity. She might be doing earthquakes, and people are like, well, she's killing people. No, she's just upset, she's hurt, she's angry, so she's reacting. She's in pain, so she's reacting. Basically, the moon was set in a system that everybody is supposed to stay in here until they grow themselves, you know, until they put their DNA up, and then they will get out. She's not anything that's negative. I would say she's more like neutral, but she serves her purpose either way. Like I said, for the matrix system, to me, I don't consider it neither negative or positive. I consider it that it serves the divine and listens to the divine, and that when people light themselves up, it will work. It will switch accordingly. But yes, it's quite powerful energy, the moon, and I mean, I often use it to, because the moon is the subconscious, and once something very interesting, all work done, let's say you want to send somebody love, or you want to send somebody healing, do it on the moon, because that's the subconscious. If you want to start a business, or if you want to start a project and you want to be very successful, do it when the sun comes up, but do not do it after the sun starts going down, because the sun and lights means the births, the light births or projects and everything like that. If you're doing it when the sun goes down, that means the death of it, rather. And that's why the ancients knew these sort of things, and they used to work according to the planets and the sun and everything else. Yes, Sarah.
Hi, is there anything we can do to activate our third eye if he's not open yet?
I thank you for reminding me of that. I forgot about that. I was supposed to finish off with saying that, yes, okay, so there's, as much as these entities and lower sort of forces, they have done many entrapments, there's also many ways to get out of that. You have to do, for everything good, you have to be patient and do work for it, don't you? You just can't have, we live in a society of instant gratification. It's absolutely horrible. It's instant gratification on every single level. It's absolutely horrible. Anything good comes with time and work and patience. So I would say that people need to look at mucoid plaque detoxes. I know it's something absolutely disgusting, and colonics, because first they need to clear out the parasites out of their system, and that will start to clear their mind. From there, I would say that you can use essential oils, lots of juice and greens. Fruits are very acidic, and they're only supposed to be used sort of in a
not so much. I see people juicing all these fruits and they're not juicing their greens. So you need to juice your greens because you need to alkalize your body. Minerals. Most people are depleted of minerals. And of course the minerals, as much as the heavy metals push out light, the minerals help absorb it. I would say using a Rife machine. There's a different levels of healing, but you have to be at it a lot. Meditations on how to pull energy into yourself from the earth, from the sun, from the moon, and things like that. I do them all the time. It's, you know, even on the plane, I have a list on my phone where I will just lay back, go into meditative state that is all about says, you are healed, or you are light, you are pure, that repeats over and over. Things, repetition, telling your body what to do, telling it, laying down with your willpower. You join three here, you do a pyramid, and then you willpower that you are healed, that you are cleared of anything negative and stuff like that. You tell your body what to do. Society's telling it what to do. You need to go ahead and learn that instead of letting everything in society, like TV and everything else, radio and everything else, tell you what to do, you can't have the power to tell it what to do yourself. So you start to become a pilot of yourself. When you take care of your soul and your body, they become one. In the Bible, the two become one. It was not about man and woman. First of all, it was not about a couple. It was about the two male and female energies and the soul and the body becoming one together. That's what it was about. You becoming a pilot. That's what it was about. Go ahead.
Well, I love the phraseology, you locked yourself up. I'm really listening to that. To become aware and awakened, and you've given us all this awareness. Now the next step to lighting myself up would be health measures, and you're talking a lot about
detoxing, so then you can absorb the light energy, and mucoid plaque detox is absolutely, probably everybody needs to do one of those. It gets all this mucoid plaque detox. It gets all of the gunk. It's not something most people know about. It's very interesting because there are people who have been very, very sick and ill, and they've done them. And it's also interesting that when people did it, they started to get rid of lower emotions because, of course, the entities are tied to all the gunk that's in your organs.
So what is this detox? What would be the first step?
Oh, wow. It's definitely not something very pleasant, as in, it, like I said, everything good takes work. So it's definitely taking things like wormwood and drinking psyllium husk with bentonite clay at night, lots of water, lots of juices, and kind of eating maybe lots of salads and just getting mostly fiber into yourself and doing it for at least a week or so, and you will see a lot of things come out that are absolutely parasitical. And it's funny, I know this lady who took some of this stuff and she sent it to the lab and they never responded back to her. They didn't want to tell her. She found some absolutely strange stuff in her system. She called some critters and she said that the lab never responded to her. So the government knows very well that parasites are what's keeping, parasites are connected to the, you think that the parasites, as much as you're connected to your soul, the parasite's connected to the negative entity. They go sort of one in one. So the government knows exactly what's happening. Also, in vaccines, they're putting liquid crystals. The liquid crystals get into your system, mess your system up. And they're also putting fungus, parasitical stuff that gets into your system, brings down your consciousness. And they're targeting children at birth. That's how much they want consciousness down.
I just thought of
something,
parasites like Candida.
Yeah. Candida, cane, again, cane, the DNA, yes. Can die, the cane to kill the DNA, Candida, yes, very quite interesting, yes.
Well, we're doing apple cider vinegar to try to get rid of the acidic makeup, because if on a pH balance, if you're acidic, you want to take in something acidic to get to the alkaline state. So that's what we're doing right now.
Are you using the pH tester to do that?
No.
You probably want to get a pH tester and go by that, because that's very important. And you need lots of juices. Plants, okay, so you need, oh sorry. Okay, so let me explain to you that fruits and vegetables have all aura colors in it. We're only eating food. Fast food is mostly colors that are very like ugly and down and dull. And so basically it's encoding those colors into your system. Those lower colors bring you lower sort of emotional stuff. Yes, this is why all of the fruits and vegetables were done to help also nurture our aura and our chakra system, and that's why they have all the colors within them.
Well, I think of a organic beet. I mean, that's about the most colorful thing mm-hmm. you can eat, these dark leafy green salads and things. Mm-hmm. So live foods, of course, are going to have more
color. Live foods, but juicing is very important because to get a juicer and to juice, like celery and cucumber, is so important for you, and to take a lot of herbs, a lot of different herbs. To get rid of parasites, it's wormwood and black walnut hulls are very good for that. And then to get a Rife zapper, the Holder Clark zapper kind of works, or the Rife machines work really, really well because you're getting those frequencies out. It's all about tuning your frequencies because they're on a lower frequency sort of tune. So
well, I just need to get my frequencies.
Yes. So you might want to check out, you can find it a lot cheaper online because I know some of this stuff. I mean, I've got wormwood tea. It's absolutely disgusting. I got it when I was in England, you know, because over there they don't believe in capsules so much. I got it in England. I tasted this stuff. I was like, oh my God. And I'm usually okay with tasting bad things to make myself well. But yeah, it's really bad. So I suggest the capsules. So unless you want to commando it, no tea either.
What's your name of it?
It's wormwood and black walnut hulls. So they're two different products. And online, you'll find this stuff a lot cheaper. Don't go buy Whole Foods. I know they have great products, but they're priced up much more. And then you want to put oxygen in your blood. Oxygen is very important. So it's good to ionize your water, have an ionizer, or even use H2O2 drops. If you're ever tired and you need to be vibrant, H2O2 drops work really, really well, food grade. I'm trying to put together a website with all of this on it right now, so I'm working on that. Go ahead.
We already talked about this a little bit, but it ties into their questions about third eye and
mm-hmm.
and lighting themselves up.
Mm-hmm.
Could you briefly explain the differences between, you know, the dark minerals, iron versus copper?
Yeah, how some are more dense. Okay, so there are metals that are more dense. Like iron and lead and all of those sort of, they're more dense metals. And it's really funny because what is the first thing that your doctor prescribes you here in the United States? You need more iron. Iron is one of the densest metals there is. The whole doctors recommend, there's all these commercials, you need more iron. No, you don't. You need copper and gold and come on, help me out here because yeah, so silver is related to the moon, by the way. So it's very good for parasites. Very, very good to get rid of parasitical stuff. Gold to the sun. So you have to imagine. Remember I said the two become one? Sun is the male, moon female. Those energies streaming through you become one and within your body, male and female energies, yes. So that helps to balance that out. So don't take too much silver. Balance it out with the colloidal gold. Try to balance it out equal like that, and it'll help tell your body to stream in equal male and female, so you won't have too much male energy or too much female energy within your body. So it's really great for tuning you on that level. What was that? It was copper. I'm thinking about them in French Creve.
It's mainly colloidal copper and gold that we discussed.
Exactly. Colloidal copper, gold, and we should be drinking out of copper, by the way, not metal. Try to get something to drink. Out of copper. The Egyptians had all this copper stuff. They would hold copper pipes because it's really good. Like the Zabra I have, there are two copper pipes. They're really good at balancing each side, and copper's just amazing. Okay, think about the colors. Think about the color of iron. In iron rust. Does gold rust? No, gold doesn't rust. Think about gold that it's basically a sort of a sun energy that's more of an eternal energy, whereas iron sort of wastes away in a way. Go ahead. Anybody else?
Well, I guess I'm a nurse, so I'm thinking about iron and hemoglobin and things like that. So I mm-hmm. thought we could maybe some iron.
Yeah, we've had someone get anemic in our family and take some iron tablets. We're going to need me. You need your blood.
That's the thing. But what you want to do is you want to go ahead and get a multi-mineral, a liquid multi-mineral, and take that. It will have just the right amounts of things within it. And I think that would be better. Whenever I look at most people, they're depleted in minerals anyhow. And just eating fruits and vegetables, even if you're vegan or whatever, doesn't cut it because they're not getting enough minerals and everything else like that. So it's better to add a very good multi-mineral into your system. Ionic multi-mineral so that your body can absorb it. So a lot of multi-minerals, your body can't really absorb. They're too big. So when the molecule is too big, your cell can't. Somebody who's really sick needs to have like the most smallest that they can do of, so the body's cells can absorb. I don't remember the word, but what's it called? What is it?
Not sure the word you're speaking of, but basically when she was saying about anemia and all that, when you have the full range of minerals,
you don't have,
you're able to, of course, utilize the gold and the copper and the lighter colors, the higher frequency ones, the less dense ones, a lot better if you have the full mineral profile. So
this is true.
This is something Sarah and I talked about, not myself, but if you do have that full mineral profile, they're all going to work together. If you're deficient in iron, of course you can get it through diet, but at the same time,
They never say you're deficient in copper or any of these. Have you noticed just iron? Like, why? What is such obsession with iron? The Iron Age. The Golden Age is gold. Yeah, there you go. And go ahead.
We assume that we don't have any entities. How do we know that we don't?
Most people like to assume they're going to heaven and they're all this stuff. They assume a lot of stuff in society, I noticed. And they're not even aware of what's really happening, sadly. Getting in touch with yourself. I lay in bed at night. It doesn't matter if I'm on a plane. If I've had 2 hours of sleep and if everybody in the world is ringing my phone off, I will literally get there, go within myself and feel. Start to try to clear your mind. If you can't clear your mind, it's because your body's toxic and you have entities, by the way. Clearing your mind is very important. Or you have a lack of minerals. Minerals seem to make, I notice people who have depression or manic or paranoid or whatever, to have a lack of minerals and vitamins. So to get all of that range of minerals and vitamins is very important. So becoming in touch with yourself. How do you think you tap into yourself? You go within. And I know it's easy to say, and most people think like, you know, oh, go within. It's just a bit like, I don't know, people meditate. But I've noticed is that there's meditation that happens, especially in society now. It's kind of a fad in LA for everybody to go to meditation and sit on the things. And it's absolutely hilarious because they're not really in touch with their souls. It's just a fad. And it does calm them down somewhat. But the meditations I'm talking about are meditations of visualization meditation. Going inside and literally feeling. You can feel your arms. You start to focus on clearing yourself. Start to push water. Imagine water pouring over yourself. Imagine your aura turning in rainbow light coming. Visualization and transcendental meditations are the meditations that you want to start to look into. And also, let's see, I should have brought my book along. I have a book where it explains this. It's do you remember the name of that book? The Tile or something? And it shows how energy works. Just try to get book on how energy works. You can find them anywhere and do some of the stuff in there. Sitting down and just clearing your mind will not do anything for you other than make you a bit less anxious and whatever else in life, but it's about getting connected when you're in. I had one instance in France where I went within and I literally saw, like I was surfing a symphony of Mozart and Beethoven, like within it was a very beautiful experience. I accessed the tune, the symphony of my body, and there were worlds within me. There are worlds within worlds. Yes, it's another part of creation. So hopefully, anybody else?
Sarah, one quick question. That's all we have time.
Go ahead.
You were talking about the destruction of the moon through the nuclear wars and all that.
Mm-hmm.
Now you're talking about the whales being affected by all of those sounds.
Mm-hmm.
Why are we allowing the nuclear stuff to go on and the technology to go on? Are we not destroying this planet by doing that? And
yes.
Can we correct it?
Okay, yes. So the elite that run this world, They go ahead and they allow this to go on so that they can have power, they can have wealth, fame, and whatever else. And essentially, they're letting the lower entities feed off of humanity. This is causing the problems that are happening. I think I explained this a while ago a bit. Sorry, and I'm getting really tired. As soon as I leave here, I'm going to like drop. So the elite are okay with the planet being destroyed. They don't really give a crap as long as they have their fame, their power, and whatever else. Do you think that they care? They're not in tune with themselves. They're not in tune with the planet. They're not in tune with the very people they're over. They don't give a crap. So basically, it's okay, they're okay with it. And humanity, unless they start to empower themselves and start to become multidimensional, how God originally wanted them, how God wants them, they're the ones who can change it. Not the elite aren't going to change it. They're going to just bring more technology and do more things and open more portals just so that they can continuously have power and continuously be where they are. It's up to each one of you guys to take control of yourselves and become your pilots, and then you will affect the planet in a very positive manner because the planet was given by God. You're overseers. I think even in the book of Genesis, he's here's the animals, here's the this, here's that. You guys are the overseers of it. So you have power over it, but it's only about, it's once you become a pilot of yourself. And hopefully I explained that good. I'm sorry, I am getting quite a bit tired now.
That's a perfect evening.
Thank you.